Hello, and welcome to this brief training on how to find what you need quickly on JSTOR. If you're not familiar with JSTOR, it's a digital library with a wide range of primary and secondary source content. Today, I'm going to take 7 minutes to show you how to conduct and refine a search to find exactly what you need on JSTOR. First, let's talk about access methods. Here we are at jstor.org. You can access JSTOR on or off campus. If you're on campus, you'll see the name of your institution or organization at the beginning of the screen at jstor.org. If you're not on campus, when you visit jstor.org, you will see a link to log in through your institution or through your library at the beginning of the screen. This will take you to a page where you can search for your institution and log in through that remote access method set up by your librarian. We are now on that login page. You can search for your institution here. No matter how you get there, you will know that you're logged in when you see the institution or library's name at the beginning of any page on JSTOR. We're on the main page. We have access through our institution. I invite you to explore this page further on your own. Now, let's talk about searching. JSTOR continually releases new content and features, so your view may not exactly match the examples in this recording. We can begin our search with a very simple search in the search bar. Here on the main page, or any other page on JSTOR. Our search has taken us to the search results page. The number of items returned in your search will appear after your search terms. Each item in the search results includes a brief excerpt that shows an example of the search terms in context. Looking at how those terms appear in the excerpts can help you decide how to modify your search. For example, I might get more relevant results if I searched for certain words next to one another. It's easy to modify your search in the box. For example, I can add quotation marks around the words that I would like to appear next to one another in my search results. After entering this slightly altered search, I have fewer and more relevant results. It's possible to narrow your search results in a variety of other ways on this results page. Let's explore our options in the Refine Results sidebar. Let's look at the various types of content my search has yielded. As you can see, there's academic content and primary source content. Notice that there are numbers after each of these categories. These tell me, for example, how many journals, book chapters, and research reports contain my search terms. You can search within your original results with this additional search box in that Refine Results sidebar. I'll add words here. Now, look at the main search box back at the beginning of the page. And notice that your search query includes those additional terms. Let's look over the results. We have narrowed our results further with the addition of new terms. As before, the excerpts show an example of how the terms appear in the text. Back to the Refine Results sidebar. Further down in the sidebar, you can narrow your search by publication date for more current or historical content. I will work with content from the early 21st century in this example. As you can see, this removes older content and narrows search results to a smaller set of items relevant to my needs. Now let's move further down the Refine Results sidebar and look at the subject areas my results fall into. These subject categories are assigned to journal and book titles as well as to research reports. The numbers here help us see which subjects contain my search terms. I can choose any of these subjects or several. Let me choose one. I can always come back and choose more or different subjects after I've reviewed my results. Here are the results. I was able to go from a rather broad idea to a more manageable set of content with my first search on JSTOR, all from this search page. Now, one more use of the Refine Results sidebar. I will narrow my results to just journal articles. We've looked at the excerpts of each result. Now let's look at the buttons for each result. Buttons after each search result give you several options before even opening any of the results. I can cite one or a full list of my results. I can save individual items to read later. I can also download a PDF. And of course, I can open the item. Here on the item page, I can do all of those actions. You'll find the cite button, a save button, and a download to PDF button on this page as well. Join us for other training videos where we will explore doing research on JSTOR in more detail. If you have any questions, use the support button to navigate to that page or contact support@jstor.org. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you learned how to quickly use the results page to get to content relevant to your research. Please try this yourself. Happy searching!